Today I'm going to talk about Cetus Protocol. Cetus is a pioneering DEX for the Sui network and Aptos. In this Cetus DEX tutorial, I'll cover how to Cetus pools work, how to add liquidity on Cetus, and I'll share the results of my active pools earnings. Additionally, I'll show you how to swap on Cetus. Here is the first pool, the Sui USDC pool. By adding liquidity to it, you'll earn a share of 6,571 Sui tokens and 30,000 Cetus tokens per day. The other pool I'm going to add liquidity to is the USDT wrapped USDC pool, which distributes 7,157 Sui and 20,000 Cetus tokens daily to all participants proportionally. An important parameter to consider is pool fees. For example, only $703 in fees were paid by users of the USDT wrapped USDC pool over the last 24 hours. While the Sui USDC pool collected nearly $200,000 in fees, the total 24-hour trading volume for Sui USDC is around $78 million. The total liquidity amount is approximately $18 million. In contrast, USDT WUSDC has a trading volume of only $7 million. But total liquidity of $55 million. You may notice that the USDT wrapped USDC pool has about 3 times more liquidity than the Sui USDC pool. However, trading volume is much higher in the Sui USDC pool, likely due to its greater popularity and higher usage. In theory, pools with larger trading volumes offer better opportunities for earning. Let's see if that's true. Let's add liquidity to the USDT wrapped USDC pool. I'm going to add a total of around $400. Take a look, I'm entering $70 in the USDT field, but the pool is requiring $432 in wrapped USDC. Liquidity pools aim to maintain an equal balance of both tokens. Ideally, I would see a split of around 200 USDT and 200 wrapped USDC, but currently the pool is imbalanced. There is around $36 million in USDT and around $19 million in wrapped USDC, which means users are buying more WUSDC and selling more USDT. As a result, Cetus requires me to add more WUSDC and less USDT to help rebalance the pool. Returning to the Provide Liquidity tab, I'll input 56 USDT here. 56 plus 346 equals just over 400, which is exactly what I need. Next, I need to swap tokens, so I'll show you how to swap on Cetus and the Sui network. I'll start by selling 56 USDC for around 56 USDT. Click Swap. Confirm Swap. Approve, and the transaction is submitted and completed. Then I'll swap USDC for wrapped USDC. I'll input 350 USDC, click Swap, confirm the swap, and approve. Swap successful. I received 350 wrapped USDC. Now go to the Cetus pool page. I'll input 56 USDT, which means I also need to add 346 wrapped USDC proportionally. Click Add Liquidity. You'll see that the price range for this pool is from 0.999 to 1.0014 wrapped USDC per USDT. This means you'll earn rewards only when the price stays within this range. If the price moves outside of this range, the pool becomes inactive until the price returns to the set range. So I'll click Add Liquidity, confirm the transaction, my position opened successfully. I'll open the Your Liquidity tab, where my positions are listed. This one is inactive, so let's remove liquidity from it and close the position. As you can see, I now have only WUSDC because all my USDT converted to wrapped USDC, but the total value remains the same. I'm going to withdraw my test amount of $2.88, click Remove. When removing liquidity, you automatically claim all your rewards. I earned some Sui and Cetus tokens. Click Approve. Liquidity removal successful. Next, I'll use the Sui USDC pool on Cetus. The process is similar. First, I'll determine the token proportions in this pool. Currently, users are buying more Sui, resulting in a Sui shortage in the pool. The token ratio is about 27% Sui to 73% USDC. I'm going to add a total of $400, so I'm entering 240 USDC, and it calculates that I'll need to add 52 Sui as well. Go to the Cetus swap page where I'll buy 52 Sui, click swap, it will pop up in MetaMask. Approve the transaction, and the swap is successful. Now I'll open the Sui USDC pool since I have the required amount of liquidity. 52 Sui and 239 USDC. Actually, this is slightly more than I want to add, so I'll adjust it to 51 Sui. That's good. Click Add Liquidity. Approve. Supply successful. Once that's done, you can come back over here to the mine position page. My two positions are now shown in the list, each with a total liquidity of around $402. I'll pause my video here and check back later to see the results. So about 2 days have passed. Let's see what we have now with my open pools on Cetus. Both of my pools are active, and Sui is still trading within this range, from $1 to $6.59. The total amount of liquidity has decreased by around $14. When I opened this pool, the total amount was approximately the same as it is now here, which is about $402. Why did this happen? Look here. Initially, I added 51 Sui and 236 USDC. Now I have received 7 more Sui tokens, but I have lost $23. This happened because over these 2 days, people were selling more Sui than they were buying. So liquidity shifted from USDC to Sui. Let's open the Sui chart. Look here. I bought Sui 2 days ago when the price was around $3.20. And now it's around $3. Since I have a significant portion of Sui in my pool, it's understandable that the total deposit value has decreased. Of course, it's not ideal because I have lost some money for now. But let's move on to the pending fees parameter. I have earned 0.28 Sui and 0.82 USDC from pool commissions. Cetus users trade using this Sui USDC pair, and I receive a share of the total pool fees. So I have earned around $1.67 from the pool commissions. The next parameter is mining rewards. I have received 0.17 Cetus and 0.04 Sui from the total amount of Sui and Cetus tokens allocated as mining rewards for this pool. Next, let's look at my USDT wrapped USDC pool. Naturally, the total amount of my liquidity hasn't changed because I'm using two stablecoins here. The pending fees are extremely low, as this pool isn't very popular, and trading volumes are much lower than in the Sui USDC pool. Mining rewards are also low because the total liquidity in this pool is around $52 million. I only have $400 in it, so I am receiving a very small portion of the mining rewards. You can open the pool details to find more information if you would like. In summary, the riskier the pool you choose, the more rewards you can earn, but you may lose money due to price fluctuations. If you select a stablecoin pool, you won't be affected by impermanent loss, but the commissions and rewards are generally lower. The same approach applies to Aptos on Cetus. Just head over to the Aptos section, where you can view a list of available Aptos pools and assess the liquidity options based on your goals and calculations. Hopefully, this was helpful. If it was, please subscribe and leave a like. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments below. I'll be seeing you in the next video.